Live from the Sioux Falls Arena, I'm Craig Maddock along with Mike Henriksen. I want to give you an update on the Class B tournament, consolation round, and it's going to be Faith advancing. They're going to beat Centerville this afternoon. As that one, a couple of seconds left, but Faith leading Centerville 60-45.
All right. Hey, we appreciate folks. You know, Craig, you and I talked a little bit about this at the tournament last week. I can remember when Larry Rohr first told us about the fact that South Dakota Public Broadcasting was going to be streaming games on the computer.
I know. You and I looked at him like he had four heads.
Exactly.
You know?
What on earth does that even mean?
There's no chance of surviving.
Yeah. Why would we promote that? Well, obviously, Craig and I were not exactly the amazing Kreskin when it came to seeing the future there. And now, of course, with all of the multiple platforms, you can watch our South Dakota High School sports and fine arts coverage for the South Dakota High School Activities Association on so many different formats, on your phone, on your tablet, on your computer, of course. And we want to say hello to folks in London who are watching online at sdpb.org. And we want to say hello to folks in Cancun who are watching online at sdpb.org. Pretty doggone amazing, and we appreciate it. And, of course, we always hear from friends and relatives from across the country also that are watching online. And especially we like to hear from those who are serving in the military. We really, really appreciate what it is that you do for us, and we are glad that we can bring a taste of home to you via the internet, or again, however it is that you are watching. And all of our games are available, and also available in the archive version. If you want to go back to years past and take a look at some older games, you can do that by going to sdpb.org. So we appreciate everybody in so many ways to support these kids. And again, doesn't matter whether it's in athletics or the fine arts, you know, South Dakota Public Broadcasting, obviously, we've got gymnastics and basketball and football and wrestling and more, but also broadcasts and webcasts of high school chorus and orchestra, all-state band, jazz band, and much more. SDPB is South Dakota, and none of that coverage happens without the support that we have continued to get through the years from viewers just like you. Please go online here. Between games is a great time to do it. At sdpb.org, become a friend of South Dakota Public Broadcasting. So much great programming, so many incredible memories brought to you no place else but on SDPB TV. And we thank you very, very much for those people that do support public broadcasting, and especially the ones who have done it for so many years so generously. Coming up, Pine Ridge Thorps taking on the Sioux Valley Cossacks. We'll be back to preview this game for you after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
And welcome back to the Sioux Falls Arena with Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN. I'm Mike Henriksen from Sports Max Radio and calling all sports. We mentioned Cancun and London. Folks are watching today again for the second day in a row, Annaba, New Zealand. And if I'm mispronouncing that, I apologize. Having never been to New Zealand, I'm not familiar with how the town names are pronounced, but Annaba, New Zealand, back with us today. So that is always great to see. Craig, let's take a look at these two teams. First of all, for the Sioux Valley Cossacks, a very disappointing game last night. And it's going to be interesting to see how they come out this afternoon. Again, they shot 25% last night from
the
floor.
And, Mike, they have four of their five starters scoring double figures. And so it was just kind of surprising that after scoring 65 points per game that they were just had a tough go at it last night. Sisseton, their bigs really defensively caused them a lot of problems. Sioux Valley had a hard time getting in the lane, going down low to penetrate down the lane. They had to virtually live and die by the three.
Yeah, they did. Late in that game, they started hoisting a lot more threes than what they normally would do. Of course, Bill Vincent is the head coach. Bill played in the state tournament for DeSmet. Played for the great Marv McCune and the DeSmet Bulldogs. Taking a look at the starting lineups for Sioux Valley this afternoon. They will go with Jake Larson, Tate Vincent, Spencer Hansen, Colin Kramer, and Kyler Krogh. Again, Tate Vincent, 6'3 and a freshman. He has seen varsity action since the time that he was in seventh grade. He was wearing a varsity jersey and getting playing time. He is the son of head coach Bill Vincent, but Tate, one of those kids that when you see him play well, you know he has earned his playing time. That wasn't coming just because of his last name by any stretch. His future very, very bright here in South Dakota in basketball. Meanwhile, a good bench rotation for the Sioux Valley Cossacks, too. But Vincent is a freshman. Colin Kramer is 6'6", just a sophomore. And so we are getting set for the Pine Ridge Thorps. Thorps come in as the number two seed, Craig.
And that was a team, too, with the head coach Lyle LeBeau, a team that has only came in with two losses on the season, scoring a lot of points. They're led by Jeff LeBeau, but unfortunately not starting last night and will not start today. He may see action today, but he's been suffering a foot injury that has really prevented him from really being the strong, dominant post player and leader on the floor for the Pine Ridge Thorps.
And as a matter of fact, he is barely warmed up here in this pregame. Jeff is the grandson of Dusty LeBeau, the legendary coach of the Pine Ridge Thorps. Dusty gathering his team there at midcourt, and all of them arm in arm. Great look at the Thorps as they get ready to play today.
You know, with LeBeau not starting, that they bring in Trent Janice and Terry Thomas. But 44, he's going to get some looks today. He's going to get it on the floor. And you can tell when he is on the floor, Pine Ridge, they make things happen offensively because you got to worry about LeBeau in the paint. And that opens up your outside shooting. And that's where Jacob Dreamer and Jacob Brown, double-digit scorers, get their looks.
Well, and LeBeau is such an outstanding passer also and very good on the defensive end. We mentioned it last night. This guy has a high basketball IQ, and I mean this in the best possible way. This is a compliment from me. He's an old soul. You know, he's got some of that basketball acumen that you'll see from guys who have been playing it for, you know, 20, 30 years or so. He just understands the game so well and understands what he can do with his body, both offensively and defensively as well. So it's a shame that the state hasn't had the chance to see the best of Jeff because of that lower leg injury, but he will see some time today. And when he was in there yesterday, he was still effective. But again, you have to wonder too, Craig, how much they play him now that they're in the consolation round of things. And so we'll be back to the Sioux Falls Arena as we've got another consolation round game to play today as Sioux Valley is taking on the Cossacks and the Thorps, two of the more unique nicknames that we've got in the state of South Dakota. You have to go a long way to find a Thorp or a Cossack, and we've got it for you coming up on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
We are ready for game two of the afternoon, the consolation semifinals, Class A boys basketball. The number two seed, Pine Ridge Thorps, and the number three seed, Sioux Valley Cossacks. Let's get the introduction of the players for this afternoon. The public address announcer here at the Sioux Falls Arena is Jeff Lukens.
Second day of the 2014 State A Boys Basketball Tournament. In this game, the guests on the scoreboard will be the Sioux Valley Cossacks. And the home team on the scoreboard, the Pine Ridge Thorps. Let's meet the starting lineups for both of these squads. Starting at center for Sioux Valley, a 6'6 senior, number 34, Spencer Hansen. Starting at center for Pine Ridge, a 6'6 senior, number 55, Trent Janice. Starting at guard for Sioux Valley, a 6-foot senior, number 3, Jake Larson. Starting at guard for Pine Ridge, a 5'9 senior, number 11, Jesse Brown. At one forward for the Cossacks, a 6-foot senior, number 23, Kyler Krog. At a forward for the Thorps, a 6'2 senior, number 23, Jacob Brown. At a guard for Sioux Valley, a 6'3 freshman, number 13, Tayton Vincent. At a forward for Pine Ridge, a 5'10 senior, number 22, Jacob Dreamer. At forward for Sioux Valley, a 6'6 sophomore, number 5, Colin Kramer. At forward for the Thorps, a 6'3 senior, number 52, Mato Wells. The assistant coaches for Sioux Valley are Jamie Granham, Tanner Thompson-Mode, Paul Santima, and Tyler Snaza. The assistant coaches for Pine Ridge are Casey Means and Corey Shangro. The head coach for the Sioux Valley Cossacks, Mr. Bill Vincent. The head coach for the Pine Ridge Thorps, Mr. Lyle LeBeau. The officials for this game, Mr. Chad DeYoung, Mr. Pete Entringer, and Mr. Luke Langner. The alternate, Mr. Nick Gottlob at the scorer's table.
And so we are set to go as Sioux Valley in the dark uniforms will be taking on the Pine Ridge Thorps.
Sioux Valley 19-4 on the year, Pine Ridge 20-3.
Pine Ridge with the loss in double overtime last night. They've got a couple other kids. We talked a lot about Jeff LeBeau, but Jesse Brown, Jacob Dreamer, Jacob Brown. They've got some fun players to watch.
Oh! That's going to be goaltending.
That's going to go.
Oh, see,
on Jacob Brown.
He was up there.
Man, can that kid rise. So give the basket to Krogh to start the game. Sioux Valley coming out in the zone. Down low, reverse. Dreamer into Janice, fall away jumper, no good. Here comes Tate Vincent, the freshman.
What's the pace of this game gonna be like, Mike? That's the big question. Sioux Valley, are they gonna wanna run with the Thorps? I think the Thorps really want up-tempo here this afternoon.
Jumper on the way, up and good. As Spencer Hansen with his first basket in the early lead for Sioux Valley. Pine Ridge going to go ahead and shoot over the top of that zone. Jacob Brown says, that's fine with me. Jumper the other way. That's up and good by Jake Larson.
I can handle this.
Yep. Yeah, more of what we saw in that first game. That'd be fine. Nice shot inside. Janice off of the nice peel. Nato Wells with the assist. Jumper is up, no good. The rebound by Jacob Brown. Both Jacob and Jesse Brown in the starting lineup, a pair of seniors. And that one went right through the hands of Janice. So turn it back over to the Cossacks.
That was a no-look pass to Janice. I think he was surprised the ball was coming his way.
Sioux Valley, of course, at one time coached by our good friend George Kiner. George, who does such a great job of running the Coaches Against Cancer Foundation here in the state of South Dakota. Ball saved back in. Selling all sorts of books, usually at state events. The three off the rim, no good, and the rebound by Spencer Hansen.
Sioux Valley is pushing tempo, Mike. Oh, and that Larson just had that one come off his leg.
Dreamer, short, rebound Hansen, and Hansen is fouled from behind. That foul is gonna go on Jacob Dreamer. First personal and the first team foul, and checking into the lineup now is KJ Graygrass. Graygrass did a nice job yesterday coming off the bench.
Pine Ridge can go 10, 11 deep on that roster. Sevalia didn't go quite that deep yesterday.
Larson, the three, comes up just short, and Graygrass with the rebound. They'll leave it for Dreamer.
Yeah, when you see that zone, the goal here is to find that open shooter along the wing. How quickly can Pine Ridge move that ball around?
Jesse Brown, they'll reverse it. And the pass intercepted by Tate Vincent. Vincent with the nice feed, the layup up and good. A beautiful feed, and Kyler Krogh with his second basket. Thorpes, the three by Jesse Brown, too strong. Dreamer, the rebound, the put back, no. Rebound controlled by Colin Kramer. The pass up ahead to Krogh, layup up and good as well. Kyler Krogh with 6 points here in the early going.
He averages 5 per game.
That pass tipped away and out of bounds, and we'll step away. You're watching the Boys Class A Championships on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. The Sioux Valley fans on their feet, and the Pine Ridge section as well. Again, a good turnout this afternoon for a Friday session. Consolation round.
We're good time to get out of town and come to the state tournament.
Yep, very much so. We're expecting a great crowd on hand tonight. There's a shot up by Brown, no good.
Oh.
And the rebound pulled down by Spencer Hansen.
Yeah.
The pass up ahead, and Graygrass came up with the rebound. A little elbow there. Is that what happened, Craig?
Nato Wells getting an inadvertent elbow in the mouth last time down.
The floater put up no good. And now Pine Ridge will control after the offensive rebound. Into the lineup, that is Jeremy Bettelhune. Pass is tipped out of bounds. Pine Ridge with such a great history of basketball. Of course, Brown, Janice, Dreamer, Bettelhune, Brings Plenty. They have had some basketball players in all of those families. Full court pressure here by the Thorpes. And if you're wondering, yes, they are named after Jim Thorpe. And a foul out top. That's going to go on Bettelyun. Jeremy, the 5'11 senior. One of the few schools in the country that their mascot is named after a real person. But uniquely, South Dakota has two of those. We've got the Thorpes and the Cobblers. Rapid City.
Add another one. I got another one for you, Mike.
Okay, the three on the way for Vincent. No good. Rebound by Graygrass.
Actually, the Mitchell Colonels are named after a guy. His last name was Colonel. He supplied the uniforms to Mitchell a long, long time ago, and so they named that after him.
Yeah, I'm still not buying that one. I'm going to be honest with you.
Oh, okay.
Folklore
or...
I don't know. I just... That just seems...
Too good to be...
Too good, almost too good to be true. But the nice thing is, as a foul whistled, oh, coming up the hobbling there is Perez De Leon. And quickly into the lineup is Jerome Slobear.
He's going to come out.
We were talking, though, about George Kiner, and George, actually, one of his latest books that he is selling is talking about South Dakota mascots, which is very cool. Jerry Miller did a lot of research on that.
That's where I got it.
I figured that was the case.
I'm sure there's someone in Mitchell will let us know if we might be wrong.
I would.
KJ Graygrass with the basket.
Yeah, but to think that there was a guy in Mitchell, South Dakota, who happened to have the name Colonel.
Oh, nice stroke.
The home of the world's only corn palace. That was a great stroke. Tri-Valley now doubling up the lead. But yeah, the Cobblers of Rapid City, named after Uke Cobb, longtime school official out there. Inside, the ball is lost, out of bounds, last touch by Sioux Valley as Trent Janice not able to hold on. Checking back into the lineup, Spencer Hansen.
Pine Ridge a little cold in this first quarter, Mike. They're make it 3 of 11 from the floor, 1 of 4 beyond the arc.
You wonder about their energy level, too. As Jerome Slobear in the lineup for the Thorpes. Long three, up and good. Bury it by Bettelyun. They expended so much energy last night. Such a tough loss. Double overtime to T area.
Coach LeBeau's got him ready today, though.
He does.
And their energy level's really high right now.
Yeah, and he's going deeper in that bench than he did yesterday already. The three is... Short, Hansen, the putback, has it blocked by Slobear. And now checking into the lineup will be Jeff LeBeau.
This is a good spot for him to be brought into the game with that bad foot. Come in as a defensive player.
Well, and if you can coax a little time out of him, the foul, is that going to be called on Graygrass?
Oh, boy, and KJ got something in the mouth there, too.
Yeah, I think he got the shoulder, actually, of Colin Kramer. Colin was going up, and I think that shoulder caught Graygrass right there in the...
Kisser.
Yep. KJ's having a rough day this afternoon.
KJ and Wells both getting something right in the mouth.
And now into the lineup is Trevor Lundeen, the 6'1 senior. He will come in for Sioux Valley. Bettelyun, take it away. Kramer lost the handle. And he'll step to the line and shoot two. The foul is going to go on Jeremy Bettelyun. That will be his second personal foul, the fourth team foul. And Colin Kramer, the 6'6 sophomore, steps up to the line.
0 for 2 already today.
Make it 0 for 3.
He's a 70% shooter. Yeah. Went 2 for 2 yesterday.
And now Vincent will take a seat, and Jake Larson comes back in the lineup for Sioux Valley.
Well, Kramer's got 10 dunks on the year, too.
0 for 4 at the free throw line. And Jeremy Bellion brings it the other way. High post to LeBeau. The up, the under, the two. So smooth.
LeBeau averages 18 a game. He had 20 last night. Oh, tough pressure.
Jake Larson controls.
Uh-oh, Bedelyun, is that going to be number three?
Yep. That's three quick fouls on him, so Jesse Brown will check back into the lineup.
Three fouls in the first quarter. That's tough.
That is the fifth team foul. Sioux Valley has only been whistled for one in the nice recognition on the inbound basket. Spencer Hansen, an easy two.
All right, let's see if they go in down low to LeBeau. Normally he'll post up.
Instead, they attack along the baseline as they did last night. Now LeBeau with the ball. Double team. He'll give it back outside. Terry Thomas.
I'm sure he'll touch it again here.
That ball knocked out of bounds by Jake Larson. Lane Lucas checks into the lineup for Sioux Valley. Also coming in is Austin Chase.
Yeah, Coach LeBeau, he's really going deep. He's already played a couple of kids who did not even get in the game last night.
That's what I thought. Taylor Tofte is into the lineup for the first time now for Sioux Valley.
All right, look for the pass to LeBeau. Normally he sets things up offensively on that high post. Although he's kind of surrounded by like four Cossacks right now.
The three isn't there. Here comes Sioux Valley with the chance to add to their lead. Tofte gets it back. Chase, no. And that's how we end the first period. Sioux Valley on top of Pine Ridge. We're back after this on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN, I'm Mike Henriksen.
Mike, both teams have put 16 shots. Put 16 shots up. Sioux Valley's made seven of them. Pine Ridge has made five of them.
So Sioux Valley with the lead, Pine Ridge with the basketball.
A lot of even numbers in this first quarter. Turnovers about the same, rebounds about the same, number of shots from the arc about the same.
And there went the hands, right through the hands of Jacob Dreamer. Jeff LeBeau is staying in the game here. Here to start the second quarter. Again, hearing various reports on the seriousness of the injury to LeBeau. And there's a nice cut to the basket by Colin Kramer.
He's got five.
But one way or the other, whatever the outcome is of that injury by LeBeau, it is gutty that he is out here and performing as well as he is. LeBeau, high post, tried to go to Graygrass down low, knocked out of bounds.
That's how the Thorps run their offense. They try to go with that high post pass to LeBeau, and then he'll turn around, look for the open Thorpe from there.
No good. LeBeau is able to get the ball. And, oh, you can tell he was in some pain right there. Jumper on the way, up and off the glass by Jacob Dreamer. Ball
nice
stripped
hands.
Away. Yep, Jesse Brown. I'm watching away from the ball. Right now between LeBeau and Spencer Hansen, there's a little extracurricular activity going on. Spencer has a pretty good-sized mark on his face. Spencer goes up and gets that one, and he's going to be fouled by LeBeau.
Yeah, I think Hansen took one in the midsection here, too, driving down the lane. He's going to have to take a couple of deep breaths here.
Checking into the lineup is Mike Bringsplenty. Also coming in is Jacob Brown back into the lineup.
But you're right, Mike. Hanson and LaBeau getting a little physical out there. Whoa!
That ball thrown away. That ball was passed to where the guy used to be. I saw exactly what Colin Kramer saw, but
he was looking right at you, Mike.
Yeah, then the player moved. Nice pass inside, and a foul going to be whistled. This will only be the second team foul on Sioux Valley so far. Foul goes on Kramer. That is his first personal. Inside to LaBeau, and LaBeau is going to be fouled by Hanson.
Yeah, I think the officials got to watch this one. I think Hanson and LaBeau, they're talking.
Pete Entringer is he's having a word with a couple of the guys. Just
whoa!
And there was a shove by LaBeau. That time he got caught. Jeff LaBeau was trying to free himself up there and gets whistled for the foul. That is the seventh team foul. So from here on out, Sioux Valley shooting free throws. Kramer with the ball. Ball lost out of bounds. Last touch by Jake Larson. Give it back over to the Pine Ridge Thorpe.
I know last night Sioux Valley really didn't do a lot of challenging in the paint on that zone defense, but the Caustics, they have been moving the ball, penetrating into the lane, trying to get something happening.
LaBeau in the lane, puts it up, wide left, no good. The tip is up, no good. Tip one more time, no good. Tip and lost and controlled by Dreamer, no good. And a foul whistled, and that's going to go on Jeff LaBeau. That time he and Vincent got tangled up, doing a great job on the boards. Was that Bringsplenty? It was. Checking into the lineup now will be Trent Janisse. He'll come in. LaBeau will take a seat. And Dusty LaBeau having a word with his grandson.
Well, there certainly is an intensity in this one. Coming in for Sioux Valley, Austin Dibert.
Tate Vincent to shoot the one and one.
He did not get to the free throw line last night. He's an 85% shooter.
He settled for a lot of long jump shots last night, did the freshman.
In fact, Sioux Valley didn't shoot a lot of free throws.
No, they didn't.
Last night.
Sisseton did, but again, that was a prime example of Sisseton being the aggressors in that game. They were taking it inside, getting to the rack, drawing the fouls. Sioux Valley relied on a lot of outside jump shooting, and the jump shots weren't falling. They shot only 25% for the game. Tofty in the lane, has it knocked away. Good swarming defense by the Thorpes. Up ahead,
nice
job by Brown.
Kept it alive.
Jacob Brown, he's one of those kids I would like to watch a lot more of. Tate Vincent with the rebound. Vincent, the hesitation, the floater, no good. Ball knocked out of bounds. It will stay with Sioux Valley.
Sioux Valley had shot four free throws last night. That was it. And they've already shot six here this afternoon.
Gray Grass will check back into the lineup for the Thorpe. Spencer Hanson will come back in as well. And also coming in is Austin Chase for Sioux Valley. Jake Larson taking a seat. Coffey will give it up. Working that perimeter against his zone defense. Shot put up on the wing, too strong. Big time rebound by Graygrass. Brown for three. Short. And the rebound controlled for Sioux Valley as Austin Divert, the 6'7 junior. Ball loose on the floor, jump ball, alternating possession. It will belong to Sioux Valley and we'll step aside. Sioux Valley on top of Pine Ridge, football score right there. And we're back after this timeout. With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen, back at the State A Boys Basketball Tournament.
Mike, Sioux Valley, 8 of 20 from the floor, 2 of 10 beyond the arc.
The inbound pass goes to Kramer, no good. He'll get it back, put it up, have it blocked, and a foul.
Jacob Brown was in there for the Thorps, knocking that one away.
And no foul, just knocked out of bounds, so it will stay with the Cossacks. Inbound pass goes to Jake Larson, who's back in the lineup. In the corner, Vincent for three, got it. That was a shot he could not get last night. Biggest lead of the game here for Sioux Valley. Pass inside to Graygrass. He has it blocked from behind by Hansen. Vincent tries to go behind the back to avoid traffic. Ball loose, knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Sioux Valley.
Boy, there's some
last touch by the Thorps.
There's some strong rebounding going underneath the basket from both teams. They're crashing the boards, getting pretty physical.
Man-to-man defense being played by the Thorps. And a foul whistled away from the ball.
Yeah, that's going to be on Hansen. He put his shoulder in. He was trying to put a screen on the play, but he leaned his elbow in to try to protect on the screen, called for the offensive foul.
And Tofty will check back into the lineup. 6'2 and a senior for Tyler. Also coming back in is Austin Divert, the 6'7 junior. Again, plenty of seniors. Spencer Hansen, Jake Larson, Kyler Krogh in that starting lineup. Austin Chase and Lane Lucas off the bench. And Lundeen. But there's plenty of young talent on this Sioux Valley team also. The shot is up and no good by Graygrass. He comes up just a little short. High screen and a foul going to be whistled. Is that going to go on Jacob Brown? It is, I believe.
Mike, it's getting physical in this ball game. There's some pretty hard screens being set. A lot of slapping at the ball for rebounds.
Tate Vincent will step to the line to shoot the 1-1. Tate now with 6 on the game.
He had 12 last night.
And here come the Thorps. They've been stuck on 14 for a while. Oh. Shot inside, no good. A rebound, and Tofty and Graygrass getting tangled up. Graygrass is going to be called for the foul.
That's going to be his first.
And it is double bonus times as Tofty will step to the line. Sioux Valley shooting 2 each time they're fouled for the rest of the half.
Officials got to really watch the rest of this half here because things are getting a little bit on the chippy side.
Free throws no good. Graygrass will check out. Coming in is Terry Thomas. Tate Vincent will take a seat, and Lane Lucas is in for Sioux Valley. It was 17-12 at the end of one. Pine Ridge with just 2 points thus far in the quarter. Shot is up by Brown, no good. And a rebound foul whistled on Sioux Valley. Come on. Lundeen will pick up the foul. Trevor Lundeen, the 6'1 senior. Pass to Dreamer. Janice inside, off glass by Bettelhune. No good. Janice to put back up and good.
Just the second basket of the game.
Jake Larson into the front court, being covered by DeLeon. And a timeout going to be called by Bill Vincent. Didn't like the way the offense was setting up there, so he calls a timeout, and he's going to get his starters back in. Hey, for the first time ever, the host of public radio's smash hit, This American Life, is coming to South Dakota. Ira Glass will appear live at the Washington Pavilion in Sioux Falls on Saturday, April the 5th at 7:30. He'll share the story of how his program revolutionized radio and spawned a new generation of storytellers. Tickets are on sale now online at washingtonpavilion.org, and all of the proceeds benefit Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Craig, are you helping out with band coverage next week?
No.
Okay.
No.
Well, the public broadcasting crew is on the road to Pier.
Don't need a play-by-play guy for that.
No, you really
those
don't.
Those musicians do a pretty good job, and those vocalists.
That's true.
I don't need to be able to wreck it.
All-State band coming to South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Nice block by Jacob Brown.
Like I say, he's one of those kids I want to watch more. Nice no-look pass to Janice in the layup.
Pine Ridge attacking that low block of Sioux Valley. I don't think that's going to change at all the rest of the game.
Vincent gives it up. Larson.
Going to the basic dribble drive. Come down the lane. Hit the open man on the out in the wing.
The long jumper is no good, and DeLeon comes up with the loose ball. Into the front court, he'll leave it for Jacob Brown.
Good to see DeLeon back in. Remember, he kind of went out with a leg injury, but he's back at it.
And shot just short. In the lane, put up by Kramer, no good. Spencer Hansen is able to run it down and save it. Kramer, off to Larson, offensive foul. Wave off the basket, a good job of standing in and taking it by Janice. As Jesse Brown will check back into the lineup.
Larson will pick up the foul. Yep, Janice just waiting for the contact.
That is the sixth team foul. Pass underneath and a foul whistled. I think Hansen is going to, is it Hansen or Vincent? It is on Tate Vincent. So stepping up to the free throw line is Terry Thomas, the 6'2 junior.
Thomas did not get to the free throw line in last night's game.
No good.
Sioux Valley brings in Divert and Tofty. The Thorpes, they're bringing in
Jerome
Slowbear. Yep. Jerome was in earlier in the game.
Free throw is up and good.
Wow, only two free throws for Pine Ridge here so far in the game.
Vincent for three, no good. Janice the rebound. Up ahead to Slowbear. Johnson, the three, up and good. Score it for Terry Thomas. And Pine Ridge climbing back in this thing. A good finish to the half by the Thorpes. And a reach-in foul going to go on Janice.
I think that's his first on the day. No doubt about it, Mike. The Thorpes been using in a very aggressive man-to-man defense.
Tyler Tofty will step to the free throw line. And coming in, Chase, Lucas, and Lundeen for the Cossacks. Also coming in, that's number 30, John Wilson, 6'1 senior. Wilson is coming in. Divert has taken a chair. I don't think we saw John last night, did we? Might have gotten in late in the game.
Late in the game.
Up, no good. Offensive rebound and then lost. But last touch by the Thorpes.
Greg Rass with the quick hands to knock it out.
Softy. Working that rotation. Corner, no good, and a foul whistled as Thomas ends up on the deck. That's going to go on number 33, Tofty. That is the eighth team foul, so they'll march the other end and shoot free throws.
Came on a push going after the loose ball, trying to get position.
Thomas will step to the line to shoot the one and one.
...54% shooter.
That one was perfect. Good rotation, gathers himself up. Bends the knees. The stroke all the way through.
Yep. 3 for 4 from the line for Thomas. 6 points.
That pass is tipped away, and it goes off in the hands of John Wilson. So it will belong to the Cossacks. Or to the Thorpes. Chance to pull even closer here. The shot up, no good. Rebound pulled down by Wilson. The heave and the hope, and it's short. And so at halftime, Sioux Valley had a sizable lead, but that has been cut as the Cossacks are on top, 28-24. With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. We'll be back to take a look at some of the highlights and stats from this first half. Right after this timeout, you're watching Class A Boys Basketball on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Championship event is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, by SDN Communications, and by the Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota.
Well, if that picture doesn't capture the yin and the yang of high school basketball action, I don't know. How do you kill time at halftime? Well, one person dances, the other one reads a book. At halftime, it is Sioux Valley with the 4-point lead. Their biggest lead was 13 in the game. And Craig, it has been the game that Sioux Valley has led throughout.
They've been getting early on, they were penetrating into the paint, getting some action. But I think Pine Ridge, they have really come on strong with that man-to-man defense. Colin Kramer gets a three. That is his second of the tournament. Jeff LeBeau with a nice floater.
And again, you can really tell just how hobbled he is. Spencer Hansen gives it up inside to Colin Kramer. Then Vincent with the three from the corner.
Three threes in the first half for Sioux Valley.
Good look at Dusty LeBeau, and there's Janice with the offensive glass and the putback. Bill Vincent, nice pass inside from Jacob Brown to Janice. And the three on the wing, up and good by Terry Thomas. And a close one here at the half as Sioux Valley on top, 28-24.
Sioux Valley 9 of 28 from the floor, that's 32%. 3 of 14 beyond the arc. Meanwhile, Pine Ridge, 9 of 35 from the floor, 25%. They were 3 of 13 from beyond that three-point arc.
A reminder that coming up tomorrow night, right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting, I'm sorry, tonight, I want to talk about tonight. There are two great concerts coming up on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. One is tonight, one's tomorrow night. Tonight it's Bob Dylan, but it's not just Bob Dylan, all right? It's the 1992 performance that celebrates 30 years in music for Bob. But listen to the performers you're going to get. Eric Clapton, George Harrison, Richie Havens, John Mellencamp. By the way, we just lost Richie Havens here recently. John Mellencamp, Tom Petty, Stevie Wonder, Neil Young, and more. It's the Legend of Bob Dylan coming up tonight after basketball. And then tomorrow night, it's the Dukes of September tour. Now, I really wanted to see this tour, but I don't have to now because South Dakota Public Broadcasting is bringing it to me. Donald Fagen of Steely Dan, Michael McDonald of the Doobie Brothers, and Boz Scaggs joined forces. It's the Dukes of September. They've got some great performances and some of their greatest hits. That comes up on Saturday night after basketball. So tonight it's the Bob Dylan 30-year anniversary, filmed in 1992. And tomorrow night it's the Dukes of September. We'll be back at halftime. It is Sioux Valley on top, 28-24. You're watching high school basketball action on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. Some of the young fans here enjoying the tournament. I am so glad that they have come out with those headbands for babies. When my daughter was small, she didn't have any hair either, and so we would attempt to put a bow on, and we were using everything but masking tape to stick that on. And of course, people would still ask, how old is your son?
They have a thing called duct tape now, Mike.
Exactly.
It worked pretty good.
We thought that was maybe taking a half a step too far. At halftime, let's take a look at some of the stats there. There's some Sioux Valley Cossack fans. There you see the field goal percentage. Both teams with 3 3-pointers. Everything pretty even here, Craig.
Spencer Hansen already with 8 rebounds for Sioux Valley. 4 rebounds for De Leon and Graygrass for Pine Ridge.
And so we are set to go with this second half of action. Good balance for Sioux Valley. Larson with 3. Kramer with 6. Vincent with 7. Krogh with 6. Spencer Hansen with 4. Terry Thomas with 6. And Trent Janice with 6 to lead the way for Pine Ridge. Don't forget, coming up tonight, our games are at 6 o'clock Central Time. That's when we start the evening session. Reminder, the basketball records and historical materials from Mariah Press and SDSportsHistory.com, presented through the support of Simpsons Printing of Rapid City and of Jamsticks.
Both clubs going with their original starters. Thorpe's will go with Brown, both Jesse and Jacob, plus Dreamer, Thomas, and Janice.
And we've got a little timeout here as some garbage floated onto the floor. And actually, Graygrass is going to get the start in the second half instead of Mado Wells for the Thorps. Janice around to Dreamer. Janice on the high post, reverse it to Brown. Dreamer for three. Oh, it was halfway down, wouldn't fall, and the rebound by Spencer Hansen.
We should get a stat. Almost made.
Yeah.
Because the Thorps have had a lot of those.
And a sweet move inside by Colin Kramer. Colin, the 6'6 sophomore, knew he had a mismatch, got his man on his hip. Janice hits the jumper.
I like that jumper right there in the paint. When you got the big guy.
On the left wing, that's Skylar Krogh. Over to Larson. No. Janice with the rebound. Ahead to Graygrass. Janice. Graygrass right back. Nice ball movement. Oh, Janice can't get it to fall. And Brown can't save it. Jacob Brown can't quite. What a move getting back on the court by Jacob Brown. I don't know if that kid high jumps, but he should. He almost took out Dale Pine there, the statistician.
He felt the wind. He got a close shave.
Nice pass inside from Hansen to Kramer. Working the perimeter are the Thorps.
See if they go into Janice here, and Janice makes something happen.
He tried to pass again. They're trying to attack along that baseline. They had some good success with that against T last night. T area and Pine Ridge with a double overtime game last night. Jumper in the lane by Jacob Brown, no good. Rebound by Spencer Hansen, and the foul on Janice.
His second.
That is the first team foul of this half. Vincent will give it up to Larson, and Larson will bring it into the front court. Vincent thought about the three. Inside, Hansen turned around. Good defensive help by Jacob Brown. Knocks the ball out of bounds. Last touch by Sioux Valley. And here come the Thorps. Jesse Brown, the 5'9 senior point guard. Gives it up to Jacob Dreamer.
Remember when we started the game, Mike, it was a very fast-paced game. The game has slowed down since the first quarter.
Vincent, the outlet with the left hand and a traveling violation on Jake Larson. Jake needed to take a dribble and didn't. A great pass with the on the outlet with the left hand by Vincent, but it goes for naught.
Oh,
beautiful jump pass inside from Dreamer to Brown. Hansen. For three, up and good. Spencer Hansen, the senior center.
His first three of the game.
Here come the Thorps the other way. Janice spins in the lane. No good, but he is fouled by Hansen. And Spencer Hansen nods his head and says, "Yes, sir, I did."
It's going to be number two on Hansen. Ah, check that third. That's his third, so the first Kosick with three fouls. First time to the line for Janice today. 58% shooter. He was 1-for-3 yesterday. He's done a great job filling in for Jeff LeBeau. Typically is the starter.
And he got that one. We'll step aside. We're back right after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Welcome back to the State A tourney earlier today.
How about the AA consolation round? Huron, the number one seed, got by Pier 72-63. I think Huron went 4-0 against Pier.
Tri-Valley with the win here at this tournament over Cheyenne Eagle Buttes this afternoon. So Tri-Valley will take on the winner of this one in our second game tomorrow.
And it was Faith beating Centerville in the Class B consolation round.
And again, a reminder that all of our sessions start at noon and 6 p.m. Long outlet pass up ahead to Kramer. There's the hammer.
Caught Pine Ridge off guard on that baseball pass.
Jumper on the way by Brown. No good. And the rebound controlled by Sioux Valley. Kyler Krogh the other way, no good. And the rebound by Jesse Brown, Jesse Brown. The biggest lead has been 13 points by Sioux Valley. Pine Ridge got it within four at halftime.
And Graygrass is going to come out. He hurt his hand.
Yep, re-injured that hand. He has been battling that.
So Wells will report in.
Mado, the 6'3 senior, he'll come in. Sioux Valley inbounds it to Tofty. Now off to Kramer, and they'll break the press. Thorpes would like to see this tempo pick up to what it was at the beginning of the game. Sioux Valley perfectly comfortable with it at this pace. Running that offense a little. Krogh tries to use the screen by Tofty. Inside to Krogh. Kick it back out to Tofty for three. No. Tip by Vincent, no good. Rebound, Kramer up, no good. Vincent tips it to himself.
The Cossacks winning that offensive rebound battle.
Tofty goes back to Vincent. Vincent double teamed on the baseline and threw it away. Here comes Jacob Dreamer. Oh. What a move. And Dreamer quickly hustles the other way. Down low. Shot put up, and no, traveling violation.
Well, the pace is picking up, Mike. He asked for the pace to be a little faster, so far both teams moving up pace.
On the post, Dreamer. They put him on the high post the last couple of times down. That time he just turns around, hits the 15-footer. Again, Jeff LeBeau has seen limited time in this game. He is battling an injury. Give it up. The three on the way. No good by Larson.
Well, Cossacks really aren't penetrating into the lane, going down low at all.
Brown, good and one.
Jacob Brown's going to go to the line for that chance for the three-point play.
Checking into the lineup now will be Jeremy Bettelhune. He will come in for Jacob Dreamer. Good camera work. Again, we appreciate that. So many of our camera operators this weekend are students getting an opportunity to get some real life experience. Just another way that South Dakota Public Broadcasting is providing educational opportunities, and that happens at all three of our tournaments. It takes quite a crew to put together 12 games in 3 days from three different locations on back-to-back weekends.
Sioux Valley had a 13-point lead, and it's now down to one.
Sioux Valley going to be patient with this set. Vincent.
There they go inside.
With Kramer not able to come up with it, the defensive rebound by the Thorpes. Can the Thorpes take their first lead? Instead, Vincent knocks it away. Ball loose on the floor. Tofty will come up with it, and then he is... Oh, it ends up in the hands of Brown, and Brown with the basket.
That is a good no call. It's a good no call.
To give the Thorpes the basket. And the foul is going to be whistled on 34, Terry Thomas.
That last play, Mike, no one had possession of the ball. It was still moving. There was no need for a jump ball. It was being batted around, and the Thorpes took advantage of it and get the layup.
And their first lead of the game. They trailed by as many as 13. Pass goes over to Kramer, off of his hands and out of bounds. Sioux Valley going through a little bit of a funk right here. They've lost a bit of their mojo. A lot of that has to do with the Thorpes.
Thorpes have scored 14 points in this third quarter. Sioux Valley's only scored 9.
And so it will belong to Pine Ridge.
Oh, timeout called here. They're going to get it. Pine Ridge going to take the timeout.
Jacob Dreamer, I believe, will check back into the lineup. South Dakota Public Broadcasting, able to provide coverage of the state high school boys and girls basketball championships and other quality programs you enjoy because of the generous support of viewers like you. Take a moment to express your appreciation by logging on to sdpb.org. Click on Support SDPB, and that way you can make a pledge. Also, a reminder that DVDs of all of our games, any of the games from any of the locations, you can buy the individual DVD, just $19.95, plus $5 shipping and handling. But if you're already a friend of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, they'll waive the shipping and handling. As a matter of fact, a lot of those can be bought on location as well. Just another way you can preserve a memory and support South Dakota Public Broadcasting. On the far sideline, that's Bettelyoun. He'll give it to Brown, and Brown with the drive and a foul going to go on Sioux Valley. That one will go on Austin Chase.
Pretty that balanced is. Scoring, Mike. So far, nobody in double figures for Pine Ridge. You got Janice with 9, Brown with 8. That'd be Jacob Brown with 8.
Jesse Brown with the basketball.
8 different players for the Thorpes have scored today.
Thomas to Bettelyoun. Bettelyoun jumper, not there. Long rebound. Tate Vincent lost the handle. Jumper off glass, no good. Rebound Vincent, and a foul whistled. And that's going to go on Jeremy Bettelyoun.
Yeah, and that's going to be number 4 for Jeremy.
He has seen limited time today, been hindered by foul trouble, and now Sioux Valley going with their 4 starters back into the lineup as Larson, Hansen, Kramer, and Krogh all check back in. Meanwhile, the Thorpes will go with Mato Wells back into the lineup. And also in is Mike Bringsplenty. Mike, 6'4 and a senior. Into the front court is Jake Larson. Ball bounces off the chest of Colin Kramer, and here come the Thorpes. Brown tried to feed it outside. It was tipped away. It ended up where he wanted it to, but not in the manner he wanted. Wraparound pass, up and score it. Mike Bringsplenty with the basket.
His first of the game.
So that's now 9 different guys that have scored for Pine Ridge. Sioux Valley working the clock. Larson, better hurry. Vincent for 3. Good if it goes, and it does. Tate Vincent, he gets a handshake from Jacob Dreamer on that one. How cool is that?
At the end of three, tied at 40, we're back after this on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN, I'm Mike Henriksen from Sioux Falls Sports Radio. From Sportsmax Radio.
Sorry. I used to be on Sioux Falls Sports Radio.
Yes, you did. Well, you still are.
Well, yeah.
It's all tied up with the Bees in the consolation round. Langford and White. White River, they're tied at 35 halfway through the fourth quarter.
That jumper on the way, up and good.
Second three of the game for Jacob Brown.
We have had two very entertaining games this afternoon. The floater in the lane by Vincent, up and good.
So a dozen for Vincent.
Tri-Valley and Cheyenne Eagle Butte had our first game today. That was an up and down affair, back and forth. This one has been a little bit slower from a scoring standpoint, but the intensity certainly there. Vincent, one on four, gives it up. Hansen with the drive to the basket, had it partially blocked, and a foul gonna be whistled as Terry Thomas will pick up the foul. And stepping to the free throw line, Spencer Hansen, the 6'6 senior.
Only the fourth team foul on the Thorps. As Sioux Valley, they have three team fouls.
Checking back into the lineup is Austin Divert, the 6'7 junior. Jake Larson will take a seat.
First free throw of the second half for Sioux Valley.
Yeah, neither team has been whistled for many fouls. That one is up and good. And Sioux Valley back on top. Ball tipped away and Krogh traveled. He came up with the loose ball, but in the process moved the feet. So it will stay with the Thorps as Jacob Dreamer will inbound it. Around to Jacob Brown. Brown rises up for three. No good. Rebound. Vincent. Vincent doesn't use the post. Now he will. And we're going to have a foul whistled as running through the high post was Bettelune, I believe.
Thomas is going to get
no,
the foul.
No, Thomas. Terry Thomas called for the foul.
Let's see if he was actually, yeah, went knocked over one of the Cossacks.
Tate Vincent set to inbound. Gets it to Hansen. Back it goes to Larson. Vincent. Brings it back out with the left hand. He's covered out there by Terry Thomas.
Winner gets Tri-Valley tomorrow for the consolation championship.
Working that perimeter, eating up some clock.
And just using kind of that weave offense.
Foul gonna be whistled away from the ball. Going to go on Jacob Brown. That will be Jacob's second personal. That is the seventh team foul.
Next one will be
sixth team foul. All right. The inbound, Vincent, long three, too strong. Kramer, the rebound, puts it up. He's fouled by Brown, I believe.
Boy, Brown got up there a couple of times, swatting it away. Oh, he got off. It's going to be on Jacob Dreamer.
It will go on Dreamer.
But Brown, he's swatting up there a couple times. He got it a couple times. And oh, boy.
Free throw is no good by Colin Kramer. Checking back in, Lane Lucas. Tofty coming into the lineup.
Kramer making a head count. Everybody's in.
Good idea. They had six there for a minute until Krogh moseyed over to the bench. Nice pass, great recognition inside. And Thomas with the bucket off the pass from De Leon. Ball stripped away, and Thomas with the ball, he's gonna be fouled.
I'm gonna get this on Tofty.
Yep.
With a reach in.
That will be on Tyler. That's his second personal, the fourth team foul. So here we are as we near this 5-minute mark. The Thorpes have committed 7 team fouls this half. That means that on every foul, Sioux Valley will be shooting at least a 1-1. Great look at Dusty LeBeau. He went in the South Dakota Sports Hall of Fame last year. Jumper in the corner, up and good by Dreamer.
First one of the game for Jacob. He's got 9 points.
A 4-point lead now for the Thorpes.
Biggest lead of the game for Pine Ridge.
Vincent gives it up, the long three, up and good by Jake Larson.
That's his second three.
Thorpes coming the other way. Brown, Dreamer, De Leon. Inside to Brown, little jump hook. That kind of went off the heel of his hand. Ball knocked out of bounds. It's last touch by the Thorpes, and we're coming back to the Pine Ridge lead after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Okay, I'm going to get this right now. With Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN, I'm Mike Henriksen from Sportsmax Radio and from Calling All Sports.
Way to go.
Did I get that right?
Right on the mark there, Mike.
I monkeyed it up the last time, so I needed to make sure and correct that. Bill Vincent, he's had so many former players of his that are now in the coaching profession.
Yeah, you read off a list yesterday. That was a long list.
It was. Lots of folks. Eric Bass doing a great job as the head coach at Flandreau. B.J. Keppen is on the O'Gorman staff. Those are just a couple off the top of my head. There's a lot more. Great feed by Vincent.
Jacob Brown will pick up his third. So Colin Kramer to the line, and Colin is in a tough day at the free throw line. Look at 0-for-5. Ooh.
I think so, and normally we're talking about a 70% free throw shooter.
One for six. I missed one.
Man, oh man. And a big rebound by Janice to maintain that 1-point lead. Weak side, they go to Dreamer. Bellyune.
That was a tough pass, a lot of traffic.
Janice tossed it away. Kramer. Go back to Larson.
Who do the Cossacks want to go to? Do they want to go to Tate and Vincent? He's their leading scorer. Right now he's not. There he is along the wing with the ball.
Spencer Hansen. Now they'll go on the double high post. And Kramer will take it himself, and he's going to be fouled. Caught out of position there with Jeremy Bettelhuhn.
That's going to be number five on Jeremy.
Jeremy came over to help defensively, just couldn't quite get there quick enough. And Jacob Brown will check into the lineup.
Kramer back at the line. Shooting two. Next foul by the Thorps. Sioux Valley in the double bonus.
Meanwhile, Sioux Valley has only been whistled for four fouls in this half. Kramer has sort of a look of relief on his face after hitting that free throw.
Third tie of the fourth quarter.
And Sioux Valley back on top. Jesse Brown, go to Dreamer in the corner for three. No, rebound and a foul going to be whistled.
Yeah, that should be on Hansen.
It will. Hansen with the foul.
Yeah, he came up over the top. Let's see what they rule it.
Yep, Spence. That is his fourth foul and the fifth team foul here in the half.
Haven't seen Pine Ridge go down low either. They've been doing a lot from the outside.
Of course, again, LeBeau is not in the lineup. Hasn't played at all in this second half.
Thomas will pick up his fourth.
Thomas with inadvertent contact, but contact nevertheless. And Tyler Tofte set to check into the lineup.
Kyler Krog has not been to the free throw line in the tournament. His first trip there in this state A tourney.
Tofte comes in. Hansen will take a seat. That one is up and good as well. Checking into the lineup now, Austin Divert back in, the 6'7 junior. He comes in, and Kyler Krog takes a seat.
Free throws may determine it, Mike. Sioux Valley, 12 of 21. Pine Ridge, 5 of 7.
And take a look here, what a nice job, turnaround jumper, not there by Dreamer, but take a look defensively. Divert was put in at 6'7". He's out at the front of that zone.
Yeah, they got some long arms out there in the front of that 2-3 zone. Makes it a little tougher for the Thorps.
Yeah, Sioux Valley going to call the timeout.
White River and Langford in a battle in the B's. It's only a 2-point ball game with not much time left.
White River and Langford. Of course, some folks thought that that would be the evening game. Speaking of evening games, coming up tonight, we've got Madison against St. Thomas More. Can the St. Thomas More defense hold Madison down enough to pick up the victory there?
Well, they'll need a much bigger defensive effort to do that against Madison. Madison's got more than just one offensive weapon.
Yeah, although Trey Vandenberg with a terrific game to open the tournament yesterday. But yeah, a lot better balance from the Bulldogs.
See if Sioux Valley here comes in a little bit of a weave, takes some time off the clock. And both clubs kind of pretty much been shooting beyond the arc.
And a foul going to be whistled. That's going to go on Jacob Brown for running through the screen.
That's the second time he's done that. He's got four now.
And that is the 10th team foul. So for the final 2:46 of this game, double bonus time for Sioux Valley. They will shoot two free throws every time a foul is whistled.
Hansen 2 for 2 today.
Hansen in double figures.
Sioux Valley got up to a 13-point lead. Then Pine Ridge came back, took a 4-point lead, and now Sioux Valley building up to a 5-point lead.
Tofty checks in. Hansen comes out, going offense for defense there as Bill Vincent. Thorpe's with the basketball. Baseline, Dreamer around. Jesse Brown, three, got it.
That's a big one.
Excuse me, Jacob Brown.
Third of the day for Jacob Brown. He's got 14.
Vincent into the front court.
He plays with so much emotion,
he
Jacob
does.
Brown. Not only offensively, but defensively. He's a fun player to watch.
He really is.
Sioux Valley taking the timeout. 16 seconds to go at the Bees in Aberdeen. Langford and White River tied at 39. Boy, Pine Ridge only had three threes in the game yesterday. Today, six.
Yeah.
But both teams really, Mike, haven't been penetrating, getting to the rack. A lot of the passing, a lot of the shots right now in this fourth quarter have been from the outside, looking for the three, maybe a short range jumper on the baseline, but really haven't been challenging anybody in the paint.
And that was the thing, Craig, yesterday, Pine Ridge, they did so much of their offense was run along that baseline. They didn't stand outside and take the threes yesterday. There you see some Thorpe fans.
Janice back in for Pine Ridge. Gives them some nice size.
And again, we have not seen LeBeau at all in this second half. He has been playing injured. And Larson with the basketball. Inside to Vincent, the drop pass, off it goes to Kramer, and he is fouled. Foul is going to go on Jesse Brown.
His first.
And again, double bonus for the rest of the way, whether Sioux Valley is shooting the ball or not. So Kramer shooting two.
He's made three in a row. They're going overtime between Langford and White River.
Ah, good game.
Fifteen for Kramer.
Back up to that 4-point lead. Foul whistled out top. That will be the... That foul is on Tate Vincent. That is the sixth team foul. So from here on out, Pine Ridge will be shooting at least a 1-1 if there's a foul whistled. The three up, no good. Rebound controlled by Jake Larson.
Now this is where you think Sioux Valley may keep the ball as long as they can. Get into that weave. Move from side to side. Look for that trailer on the low block. But they're just going to do this. Thorpe's are going to have to foul here pretty soon because Sioux Valley will do this the rest of the game.
A drive by Larson. He'll kick it back out to Tate. That jumper up and no good. Kept alive by Kramer. Knocked out of bounds. And last touch by Jacob Brown. So Sioux Valley will keep the basketball. I'm a little surprised that they attacked it all there, Craig.
Yeah, me too.
Larson drove in, thought he was going to have an open layup, didn't. So he tried to kick it back outside. The Thorpes are going to take a timeout. Pine Ridge with a couple of timeouts remaining, as does Sioux Valley.
Well, leading scorers for Sioux Valley, Kramer with 16, Vincent with a dozen, and Hansen with 11 for Pine Ridge. Jacob Brown with 14. Then you have Jacob Dreamer and Trent Janice with 9 apiece.
Gotta make sure the hair looks good. I may be on television.
Perez DeLeon gonna report back in for Pine Ridge.
And so the possession arrow belongs to Pine Ridge. Thorpe's going the second half without Jeff LeBeau.
And they're going to bring some man-on-man pressure.
So far, Sioux Valley has used well over half a minute in this possession. Spencer Hansen going to leave it for Tate Vincent. Back to Hansen, and the clock goes under 1 minute. Back to Vincent.
Watch the weave. When do they foul? There's the foul, and the foul going to be on Jesse Brown.
For Jesse, that's just his second.
Well, they fouled Tate and Vincent, and Vincent is an 85% shooter. He hasn't missed today. He's 4 for 4. That's what Pine Ridge had to do.
Oh, and he misses that one. Checking into the lineup, Mike Brings-Plenty. Brings-Plenty comes in, and Janice takes a seat. Up to a 5-point lead. Again, the Thorpes don't have to go for the three here. Jacob Brown inside to DeLeon. Back to Dreamer, DeLeon. Knocked out of bounds, last touch by Sioux Valley. It will stay with Pine Ridge.
Two possession ball game. Thorpes, I think, need a quick basket here. Can't let much more clock run.
Jerry Thomas will check back in.
He's one of their 3-point shooters.
Jacob Brown lets the defender go by him. Oh, that was halfway down. Hansen with the rebound, but then through the hands of Jake Larson.
I don't know if Jake took his eyes off the ball, but that ball came right down near his ankles and went right through his hands.
The door still slightly open. Dreamer, three, no. Long rebound, Brown, right side, three, good. Up and good by Thomas.
His second of the day.
Now you got a foul again, and a foul whistle. That's going to go on Jesse Brown. That will be his third. Tate Vincent will march to the other end.
He's 5 of 6 on the day.
Again, earlier today, it was Tri-Valley with the victory.
Cossacks not going to put anybody on the line. They're all back for defensive purposes. Two possession ball game. Yeah. I think they have the score wrong, Mike. I think it should be 54-58 because that last one was a three. Did they count it as a three on the scoreboard? They're just rechecking.
Yeah, there you go. You're correct, Craig. Good. Good call there.
So it's still, unless you foul someone beyond the three-point arc and they make it, it would be a one-possession ball game.
No good. Rebound controlled by Sioux Valley, and that is going to do it. as Terry Thomas will commit the foul.
And that will be his fifth.
And Sioux Valley will be taking on Tri-Valley tomorrow for the Consolation Championship. Mado Wells will check into the lineup for the Pine Ridge Thorps. And Vincent will step to the free throw line. Tate nails that one. Coming into the lineup, Cole Hauge. Also in is Zach Pitts. Let's see, number 22 is Tegan Holter. Number 32 is Hunter Tejan. And who am I missing?
Pine Ridge bringing in Jerome Slobear.
Slobear comes in for Dreamer.
We had two good games here this afternoon.
We did. This was an entertaining Friday afternoon session. And I am really looking forward to tonight, as it's semifinal night. A lot of people will tell you the best night of the tournament, best session of the tournament is Friday night, even better than the championship, because that's up, no good.
That one almost went down.
It did. Because you've got four teams going for the title that are still alive. Lots of intensity coming your way tonight. But after being tied at 40 at the end of three, Sioux Valley pulls away for the 60-54 victory over Pine Ridge. We'll be back to wrap this thing up for you after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcast.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Championship event is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, by SDN Communications, and by the Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota.
With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. The Sioux Valley Cossacks had a 13-point lead. Pine Ridge came back to take the lead, but Sioux Valley regained it and spread it out, winning by 6, 60-54. Let's take a look at some of the highlights of this afternoon's action. In that second half, there's the breakaway dunk by Colin Kramer, his 11th dunk of the season. Nice job inside by Dreamer from the elbow. A good pass, reverse it around, and score it for Mike Bringsplenty. Bill Vincent then off to Tate Vincent for three at the quarter, and take a look at this. Love that. He gets the low five from Jacob Dreamer at the end of that quarter. And then Jacob Brown with the shot. Vincent puts it up and good. Good luck at Dusty LeBeau, the Hall of Fame coach. The three in the corner is up and good by Jacob Dreamer. Then Jake Larson knocks down the three, and the Sioux Valley fans very happy. Another three up and good by Jacob Brown. One more time on the wing, up and good by Terry Thomas, but it's not enough as Sioux Valley hits free throws down the stretch and pulls away. Craig, some of the stats?
Double doubles for Colin Kramer and Spencer Hansen for Sioux Valley this afternoon. Kramer, 12 boards, 16 points. Spencer Hansen, 11 boards, 11 points. Also 17 points from Tate Vincent for Sioux Valley. Pine Ridge, they were led today by Terry Thomas with 11. Oh, and also Jacob Brown with 14 on the day.
And so it will be Cheyenne Eagle Butte taking on Pine Ridge tomorrow at noon, followed by Tri-Valley and Sioux Valley tomorrow afternoon following that one. We'll be back to wrap up our day from this afternoon's session in Sioux Falls right after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. Again, congratulations. Sioux Valley picks up the win over the Pine Ridge Thorpes 60-54 earlier today. It was Tri-Valley with the victory over Cheyenne Eagle Butte. 83-71, a very entertaining game. Coming up tonight, St. Thomas More, the defense, taking on the defending state champs, the Madison Bulldogs, with a 35-game winning streak. And then Sisseton, who turned a lot of heads last night against a very athletic T-area team following that one. So we'll see you at 6 o'clock Central, 5 Mountain. For all the men and women on the crew for South Dakota Public Broadcasting, thanks so much for joining us. I'm Mike Henriksen. We'll see you tonight, 6 Central, 5 Mountain.